Hey everybody, this is the Chaz Man Show. My name is Chaz Riddle and I'm coming to you from my car again. And the reason why is because I'm going to be working all day tomorrow, which is Friday, at Andrews Air Force Base, playing a general down there all day long, doing some training videos. But anyhow, I want to take this opportunity to remind you that you have less than 30 days until Avengers Endgame comes out. That comes out April 26th. Again, that's my mom's birthday. Send her a card. Wish her happy birthday. She's going to be 39. But anyhow, for those of you out there that are unfamiliar with the Marvel Cinematic Universe, there's about 21 movies out there for you to watch. Now, some of them are good, some of them are great, some of them you can skip. So here's my recommendations. Of the Iron Man movies, watch Iron Man. You can skip 2 and 3 unless you just want to know about Natalie Rushman because she's introduced in Iron Man 2. And if you want to know some backstory about the Arc Reactor and Ivan Venko and the Mickey Rourke character and all that stuff and Hammer. And also you'll see that Rhodey is replaced in Iron Man 2 by Don Cheadle. It was originally played by Terrence Howard, but there was some negotiation problems there with his contract. Okay. Iron Man 3 takes place after the first Avengers movie, so there's a lot of traumatic experiences there for Tony, and he has to deal with PTSD. They introduce a character called the Mandarin, but it doesn't really pay out, so you can skip Iron Man 3, even though it made great amount of money at the box office. Now, all these movies are enjoyable. I'm just telling you the ones you can skip and still be okay with. When it comes to the Thor movies, the first Thor is great. The second Thor, The Dark World, not so much. Has to deal with dark elves. You do get to see Asgard a lot more. But the first Thor lets you know about Asgard and Thor's hammer and the relationship Loki has with Odin. Okay, so that's that's one of the three Thors. That's a great one there. Now, Thor Ragnarok, that is the best of all the Thors. You want to check that one out after seeing the second Avengers, which is called the Age of Ultron, because you'll find out that the Incredible Hulk wasn't played by Edward Norton in the Incredible Hulk movie, but then they replaced him with Mark Ruffalo. But anyhow, you'll find out what happens to the Hulk at the end of the Age of Ultron, and you'll find him in Thor Ragnarok. Not a big spoiler. It's in all the previews there. Okay, so now coming around the corner to see the Captain America movies, you definitely want to watch the first one, Captain America: The First Avenger. You want to watch the second one. It's called Winter Soldier. It's the introduction of Bucky Barnes as more of a more prominent character. In the first Avenger, Captain America: The First Avenger, you get the introduction of Red Skull and the Tesseract. So you want to watch that. When it comes around to the next Captain America movie, it's called Civil War. That is the introduction of, the Black Panther and Spider-Man, which they have their own movies out there. You can check them out. But you don't really need to have a backstory for Spider-Man because everybody knows who Peter Parker is and how he got his powers. They do something kind of cool with Aunt May in Spider-Man Homecoming, but that's just something you can check it out. It is a good movie. The only thing I really don't like is that it's too prominently features too prominently Iron Man. And so it takes away from the Spider-Man mythology that he gets all his everything from a spider. And he does, yes, but, you know, Tony Stark comes along with his spider suit that he gives to Peter Parker, which kind of takes me out of it a little bit, but that's for you to decide. There's a Doctor Strange movie. Introduction of Doctor Strange. Stephen Strange is a world-class surgeon, but he's also a world-class asshole. But this is how he learns the mystic arts, so you can check him out. And then as far as Black Panther goes, you'll get T'Challa and how his special relationship is with his father. And you learn a lot about Wakanda and the source of vibranium. Now, as far as the next movie, as far as the movies go, you want to check out the first Guardians of the Galaxy. You'll get to meet Star-Lord and Nebula and, her name escapes me right now, but Gamora. And you get the backstory there of another Infinity Stone. You get to meet Drax and Groot. The best part of the Guardians of the Galaxy movie for me is the line, "We are Groot." Now, that's Vin Diesel plays that character. And you'll understand the relationship between Nebula and Gamora, and their relationship with their father, who's Thanos, who's the world-class asshole of the universe. But anyhow, and then the next movies you can watch are obviously the Infinity War, the next Avengers movie, which leads up, which actually starts at the very ending of Thor Ragnarok. So it all ties together. And the movie you want to watch after that, if you really want to, is Captain Marvel. Not a big Captain Marvel fan. The best parts of that movie are the cameo by Stan Lee and the end credit scene. So there you go. There's my rundown on all the movies. Three Iron Man. Skip number 2 and 3. Three Captain Americas. Watch all three. Three Thors, you can skip number 2. Black Panther, Spider-Man Homecoming, and Doctor Strange. You know, they're all good movies in their own right, but you don't have to watch them. They all tie in, of course, and Captain Marvel. You can check her out if you want to. And of course, okay, so the last one is, let's see, the Guardians of the Galaxy movies. Peter Quill, good flick. And I didn't mean to mess it up, but there's Ant-Man and there's Ant-Man and the Wasp. My car is now stopped so I can look at the camera. Stick around for Ant-Man and the Wasp, the end credit scene, because it has a lot to do with the quantum realm and it has a big tie-in to Avengers Endgame. Now, I think that gets you all caught up on all the movies. So, if you have any questions about any of them, I'm not an expert, but I know a lot. So reach out, leave a comment at the end of this video. It'll be great to have all you guys there at the movie theater so we can get some feedback. I'd like to get some feedback on what you thought of all these movies and just counting down the days to Avengers Endgame. And there you go, guys. That's my video for, this is my third attempt at doing this today. But the first two times, my video kept breaking up. And the second time, I ran out of space on my hard drive on my damn phone. So I had to do this over again. So anyhow, guys, if you like this video, like it, share it, subscribe. And we'll have another video out for you on Monday, because tomorrow I'm going to be busy all day. Anyhow, have a great weekend, guys. Enjoy the movies. Bye.